Hi children, good morning. This is Mrs. Cecilia, your English ma'am. Welcome back to our English class, children. Children, I hope you all are safe. Are you ready with your SP books, children? Take out your SP books. And now, today I am showing you some video. So watch the video, children.
Words used in place of naming words.
Hello, my name is Parth. Parth is 8 years old. Parth lives in Delhi. Parth has two friends, Ria and Rahul.
Did you notice how many times Parth's name is being repeated? Parth looks more and more confused. Let us try and introduce Parth again.
Hello. My name is Parth. I am 8 years old. I live in Delhi. I have two friends, Ria and Rahul.
The word I is used in place of the naming word, Parth, to avoid repetition. The word I is used when a person is talking about himself or herself. This is Ria. Ria is 7 years old. Ria lives in Delhi. Ria is Parth's friend. Ria has a younger brother, Rahul. We have repeated the name Ria 4 times. Let us replace Ria with another word and read the sentences again. This is Ria. She is 7 years old. She is Parth's friend. She lives in Delhi. She has a younger brother, Rahul. The word she is used in place of the naming word Ria. The word she is used for a girl or a woman. This is Rahul. Rahul is 5 years old. Rahul is Ria's younger brother. Rahul likes to play football. Rahul has a dog named Sushi. We have repeated the name Rahul many times. Let us try again. This is Rahul. Rahul is 5 years old. He is Ria's younger brother. He likes to play football. He has a dog named Sushi. The word he is used in place of the special name Rahul. He is used for a boy or a man. This is Rahul's dog, Sushi. Sushi is a furry black and white dog. Sushi plays with toys. Sushi likes to drink milk. Sushi is a good dog. Let us try again without repeating Sushi's name. This is Rahul's dog, Sushi. It is a furry black and white dog. It plays with toys. It likes to drink milk. It is a good dog. The word it is used in place of the special name, Sushi. The word it is used for things and sometimes for animals.
I, he, she, it are words used for one person, place, animal, or thing. When there are more than one, the words we and they are used. We are watching a film. They are playing together. We use you when we talk to someone else.
Children, you watched about pronouns. Pronoun is a word that replaces the name of a person, animal, or thing. So, the words which we use in the place of naming words are called pronouns. The word I is used when a person is talking about himself or herself. The word she is used for a girl or a woman. The word he is used for a boy or a man. The word it is used for things or animals. Children, the words I, he, she, it are used for one person or for one animal or for one thing. When there are more people, more things, more animals, you should use we, they. And if you are talking about someone else, even they are one or if they are more, you should use you. Have you understood, children? Now tell me, what are pronouns? Pronoun is a word which you use in the place of naming words. What are they? I, he, she, it, they, we, you. Children, now repeat after me. A pronoun is a word that replaces the name of a person or animal or things. They are I, he, she, it, we, they, and you. Children, let's see some examples here. Now I am reading the first one. Gia and Meena are friends. I repeat again, Gia and Meena are friends. Gia and Meena are two people. So we can replace Gia and Meena with a pronoun which is they. So we must use they instead of naming words Gia and Meena, and we should say the sentence as they are friends. So children, which pronoun we use for the naming words Gia and Meena? Yeah, you are right. It's they. Have you understood, children? Let's go to the second sentence now. Tarun is a dancer. I repeat again. Tarun is a dancer. Tarun is a name of a boy. So which pronoun we can use for boys, children? Boy or men? Yeah, you are right. He. So we must replace Tarun with the pronoun he. So we should say the sentence as he is a dancer. Understood, children? Now let's read the third one. The dog is sleepy. I repeat again. The dog is sleepy. So which pronoun we must use for things or an animals? Yeah, you are right. It's it. So instead of the dog, we must use a pronoun it. And we should say the sentence. It is sleeping. Have you understood, children? Let's move to the fourth one. Manu and I are watching cartoons. I repeat again. Manu and I are watching cartoons. Manu and I should be replaced with the word we. The pronoun we. Why we must use the pronoun we? Why not they? Because the person who is saying the sentence is watching cartoon along with Manu. So children, whenever you get a person name and I in a sentence, you must replace the person name and I with the pronoun we. Have you understood, children? Okay. So we must say the sentence as we are watching cartoons. Understood, children? Now let's move to the fifth one. Anu is a brave girl. Anu is a name of a girl. So which pronoun we must use for girl or woman, children? Yeah, you are right. It's she. So children, we must replace the naming word Anu with the pronoun she. So we must say the sentence as, she is a brave girl. Have you understood, children? I hope you understood how to use pronouns in a sentence. Children, now all of you, take out your SB books. Open page number 37, children. Have you opened your books, children? Did you take page number 37? Now all of you see the green color heading. Learn the language. Learn the language. I am reading the heading given below. Words used in place of naming words. So we are learning words used in place of naming words. These are called pronouns. They are nothing but pronouns. Children, put the finger in the next line and listen carefully. Read these sentences carefully. Now I am reading the next one. Shanu was too small to carry the baby in her lap. So here we are using a pronoun instead of Shanu, that is given in the red color. Which pronoun is given over there, children? Yeah, you are right. It is she. So now we'll read the next sentence. She was too big to sit on Dadu's back. Put the finger in the next line and listen carefully, children. Here, she is used in the place of naming word Shanu in the second sentence. Now I am reading the next sentence, children. Keep finger. We have learned that the words I, they are given in the red color. Put your finger over there, children. I, he, she, and it can be used in the place of naming words. I repeat again. I, he, she, and it can be used in the place of naming words. Now I am reading the next sentences. Keep your finger there, children. Now let us learn how to use we, they and you. Read these sentences and see how the words in bold have been replaced with we, they and you. Children, now I am reading the sentence which is given near the first dot. You can see four dots. I am reading the sentence which is near first dot. My brother and I study in the same school. So children, I have told you, when you get I along with any other name, which pronoun we must use, children? Yeah, you are right. We. Now see the sentence given below. We walk to school together. So who are we here? Brother and the person who is saying I. Is it clear, children? Children, now I am reading the sentence which is given near the second dot. Put your finger and listen carefully. Anu and Farhan are in the park. So they are more in number. Anu and Farhan are two people. So which pronoun we must use, children, here? Yeah, we must use they. So I am reading the sentence which is given below. They are playing football. Is it clear, children? Now I am reading the sentence which is given near the third dot. Kavya, you are a good dancer. When we are talking to someone, we must use the pronoun you. So here the person is talking to Kavya, so he is saying to her, Kavya, you are a good dancer. Have you understood, children? Now I am reading the sentence which is given near the fourth dot. Reema and Amit, you must polish your shoes. Here also, the person is talking to Reema and Amit. So when we are talking to one person or else more than one person, you must use the pronoun you because you are talking directly to them. So he is saying, Rima and Namit, you must polish your shoes. Is it clear, children? Now I am reading the sentence which is given below. Here, the words we, they and you have been used in the place of special names of the people. Children, I hope you understood what are pronouns and how to use them. And don't worry, tomorrow we will learn more about pronouns in the next class. See you tomorrow. Bye. Take care.